always wanted one of these. Welcome to Fast Friday. Hi everyone, welcome to Pal to Tech. Today we are talking about defective pixels that will most likely appear on your Fujifilm camera's sensor. In many cases, they are perfectly normal, but you should have a good understanding of what they are, as well as a tool that's right in your camera that can help you to fix them. There are three kinds of defective pixels that might appear on your camera's sensor. The first is a dead pixel. Basically, this pixel's a goner. It's not receiving any power from the camera, and there's nothing that you can do on your camera to fix it. Now, a dead pixel is permanent and it will not go away over time. Thankfully, this type of pixel defect is less common than the others. Now, the other two types of defective pixels are hot pixels and stuck pixels. These are very similar. Hot pixels can sometimes happen as a reaction to the buildup of electrical charges that get into your sensor area, particularly as your sensor heats up. You'll often find them usually during long exposure shots above ISO 800. They're called hot pixels because they will only appear when your sensor gets warm during those conditions. Hot pixels are normal and they do come and go during the lifetime of your camera. Stuck pixels are very similar to hot pixels, except they can appear anytime, not just when the sensor is warm. They are generally a colored pixel and they keep the same color all of the time and appear in the same spot on your image over and over. If I zoom into 400%, have a look at that. You see that right there, that red spot. I can see some additional ones right here as well. Fortunately, Fujifilm includes a feature in a number of their cameras that will help you to fix these defective pixels. The feature is called pixel mapping, but it doesn't actually repair the defective pixels. Rather, just like the name says, it uses mapping functionality to take data from the other pixels that are immediately around the defective pixel, and then it puts that data where the dead pixel should be. Basically, it's like the spot healing tool in Photoshop, the single pixel slider in Capture One, or the spot removal tool in Lightroom. Here's how to use it. Go into your camera's IQ section and look for a choice that says pixel mapping. Go ahead and choose that and it'll tell you to start pixel mapping. Simply press OK. And that's it, you're all done. Now there is a test you can do to see if you have hot pixels on your camera sensor. First, make sure that long exposure noise reduction is turned off. You'll find that in the IQ section of your camera. Next, you'll want to put the ISO dial all the way down to the base ISO of 160. Then set your shutter speed to about 10 seconds. You may need to put your shutter type to mechanical shutter if it's an electronic shutter. Go into shutter type and make sure that's in mechanical shutter. Put your aperture to f16 or the smallest aperture you have on your lens. And finally, put a lens cap on your camera. Then take a photograph with your lens cap on. Now, as soon as you're done taking the first photo, immediately take a second photo. But this time, make sure that your ISO dial is set to 800 and your shutter speed is set to 1/1000th of a second. You're gonna wanna be looking at the second photo when you review your shots. One important thing to know here, when you take your shots, make sure that you shoot in JPEG format and not RAW. And this is because a number of RAW processing programs, such as Lightroom, will automatically clean up the defective pixels once the RAW file is imported into the program. Therefore, to see the defective pixels, you should be looking at the straight out of camera JPEGs. If you'd like to learn more about defective pixels, there's a great article in Photography Life that I'll leave a link to down in the description below this video. The pixel mapping feature on Fujifilm cameras is not foolproof, and it definitely doesn't work all the time. But it's worth using if you happen to notice an increasing number of defective pixels in your images. As I said, a few defective pixels can be normal and can and will happen to all cameras over time. Well, thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. And if you did, be sure to give it the like and subscribe. I will be signing off for now. Have a wonderful weekend, and I will see you in another video next week. Take care.